discussion on metallography. I'm Sandeep Sharma from Magnum Opus International. So in our last video discussion we had discussed in general about the metallography sample preparation and the different steps in that. So just to brief you up again, the different steps we have are: number one is sectioning, that is cutting down the sample. Second one is mounting. Third one is coarse grinding and fine grinding. Fourth is polishing, that is dry as well as wet polishing. And fifth one is the etching. In this part of the video, we will take up the fourth step, that is essential for the metallography sample preparation. So let us discuss the polishing of a sample. That is from the lastly we had discussed the coarse grinding. So now we come to the polishing section. Now in this section I must clarify that for polishing we are going to use the abrasive silicon carbide dish or the alloxide dish, which are the coated abrasive medias. So basically these coated abrasive media, which are suspended in water solution, that is aluminium oxide powder or alumina paste, the combination is going to be used for the polishing. Here the purpose is to generate the final mirror like finish with clear structures on the sample. This is the final stage of sample preparation. Only the chemical etching part would remain after this. Okay, so let us discuss the polishing of the metallography samples. Now first thing that come to my mind is to tell you that polishing could be either dry or wet as per the requirement. If it is a wet polishing, then you will need alumina paste of different microns, okay, which is suspended in water. So that is first thing. Second thing would be, for the finest polishing or the crystal structural view, we would use the diamond paste also at a later stage. So here the grit size would vary from 150 grit to 600-800 grit. This is for coated abrasive dish I am talking. Then second one is going to be the velvet type of cloth that we'll use for the final stage of polishing. Okay, so these are the two medias we are going to use. There would be three stages in this polishing. To begin with, we'll take a 25 micron suspended alloxide paste on a nylon cloth. The final layer resulting from the previous grinding procedure should be completely removed with rotation rate of 150 rpm. Means we have to increase the speed of rotation in the range of 150 rpm. The time required for this complete stage of polishing would be between 1 to 3 minutes. Okay, so within 3 minutes the sample will get polished. Again, here the important thing is which machine are we going to use for polishing. So here first machine that could be used is a single dish wet lapping polisher, which has a facility of the water inflow. Second, that is most commonly used and highly used, is a double dish polishing machine, which could have either 8 inch or a 10 inch dia dish on it. Again, 25 micron velvet cloth on the above dish are used in this stage. The grit size, to be precise, for the whole range is going to be 150 up to 800 or 1200 grit size of silicon carbide dish. Could be waterproof dish or self-adhesive whichever you want to use. If they are not self-adhesive, you can clamp them manually with the ring. Okay. Now, what is going to be the speed of these polishing machine? So, it is a variable speed polisher ranging from anything between 50 RPM to 1200 RPM with digital display, so that you are able to see at what speed it is basically working right now, right? Then comes the final point, is the power, input power of these machines. So that is, these machines are going to have 230 volt for the single phase or 440 volt for the three phase power, input power that is available to it. So once you have finished polishing with 25 micron suspended alloxide paste on a nylon dish, the second stage for a finer polishing that we will take would be 5 micron stage, and the final polishing with this is going to be with 1 micron suspended alloxide paste on a nylon paper. So after the final stage of polishing is done, you have to be careful washing of the specimen and the operator's hand. They need to be very properly washed, and the surface, final surface of the sample polished, must not be touched with your hand. Okay, so you have to take care. Now, how would the sample look after this polishing stage? So basically, the sample will have a mirror-like finish. The surface would be mirror-like. Now again, the diamond abrasive, either the powder or the suspended paste, is used mostly for the final stage polishing to clearly outline the grain boundaries and the grain structures. Okay. Again, in lieu of the diamond paste, cerium oxide is also used in the aluminium and the other soft metals. Once you have polished, once you have finished the polishing, then you can finally take the sample to the next stage, and the final stage of sample preparation, that is going to be etching. So I think this is what we have in the polishing section. If you have any queries, you can definitely write down in the comment box, or you can come back to me on my mail ID. My mail ID is sandeep@magnumopusinternational.com. Thank you, goodbye. See you in the next and the final video of this series, that is going to be etching. And then we will further come up with more videos on how to observe the sample on a microscope, what type of microscope it is, what is the combination of the eyepiece and the objective piece that we have to keep while observing these samples, how is the light adjustment, what is the focusing, how it is done, all these matter we are going to discuss. Again, we will also deal with the camera that is being used here to capture the image, and how we can take that into the software and have image analysis, complete reporting on computer. Okay, so thank you, goodbye.